Hey there, I was recently asked the question what AI tools I personally use, and I've seen a lot of videos online about AI and how glamorous it can be and how effective it can be to somebody's life. But personally, I feel like a lot of the tools that are showcased are not ones that everybody uses, like honestly speaking. And I feel they can be good to use once in a while or maybe to wow an audience. But here are my personal top 10 tools that one can use to actually work and to be effective in their work, whether it be remote jobs or your actual office job. So here's my list. I will start from the ones I use the most to the ones I use intermittently, maybe every second day. My first tool would be Bing AI. Since I registered for the Bing Developer Program, I would say it's been my number one tool of use, mostly because I'm mainly online. And when I'm online, I'm either doing one project or the other, so I end up using it to do essentially what ChatGPT does, but it's more streamlined and it can easily be opened just by clicking the portal on the side. And I feel that is significantly better than having to go to the ChatGPT website every time I need something, which is why, spoiler alert, ChatGPT is not on this list. Even though it is a very important AI, and one could say it started off the whole craze of AI, I personally use the Bing AI. That's my tool of choice and what I would recommend to anybody that has access to the Bing AI program. My second tool of choice is what I use to create images. I personally use Stable Diffusion because I feel it's much better and intuitive than Midjourney. And as well as being intuitive, I feel that you can easily download the repositories and everything you need to run Stable Diffusion and use it from your system if your system is powerful enough. And it's a lot easier to store your data off the cloud, so you can have everything, all your searches and all stored on your system as opposed to on somebody's database. So your searches are more private and you have full control of what you want to create. I personally feel that Stable Diffusion is one of those tools where you can let your creativity fly. You can design whatever you want within the confines of prompts, and it's better than Midjourney in the fact that you're not limited. You don't have to pay for excess use. So long as your CPU can handle it, you can use it to your heart's content. I personally use Stable Diffusion to build websites. If you check out my website, lowgreatwall.com, you can see an example of what you can do to build websites using Stable Diffusion, as well as the other tools I'm going to mention, such as the first one I mentioned, which was Bing AI, which you can use exactly like ChatGPT to develop write-up for your web page. The third tool I use is Topaz Gigapixel. I personally see Topaz Gigapixel as one of those tools that has been there for a while and it keeps updating to stand the test of time. Before the AI craze, it was there, and now it's just getting better and better, and with each development, it gets more and more advantages to those of us that have been using it for a while. What Topaz Gigapixel is essentially is just an AI upscaler. It takes your images and it makes it better. I feel Topaz Gigapixel is better than a lot of the current AI upscalers that have been made to ride the AI wave right now. It is one of those tools that has a lot of different AI models, and they've trained these AI models for a while as opposed to other AI tools that are just coming out. Although Stable Diffusion does have its own AI upscaling model, I personally would still say that Topaz Gigapixel is better because it's one click away from opening and one click away from running. However, if you are on a budget, Stable Diffusion can handle AI upscaling, and the upscaling is decent enough to use. My fourth tool of choice would be Topaz Video AI. Topaz Video AI is one of those tools where You either know about it or you don't. Topaz Gigapixel AI, you can stumble upon it if you look for it, but Topaz Video AI is one of those tools where you either know about it or you don't. It does the exact same thing like Topaz Gigapixel, except for with video. And the reason a lot of people either know about it and can't use it, or they don't know about it, is because of the CPU usage that it takes. It's tasking on a system, which is why the word around it is not really circulated, because it does require a lot of system usage. And it is expected because you're dealing with files that are large. My fifth tool of choice for somebody trying to do remote work would be PDF GPT. It is essentially a function of what Bing AI or ChatGPT can do, but it's more streamlined. Essentially, to summarize what it can do, it would be taking information from a page or a document and creating summaries for you so you can read through and analyze them easier without having to scan through large documents. It can be very useful, especially for me when I need to go through less reports or when I need to go through large content. Instead of having to go through 30 plus pages, I just read maybe a page worth of summary, and it makes life more efficient. It's not really a cheat code, but it just makes things more efficient. My sixth AI tool that I personally use, but not as much as the others, would be Adobe Enhance AI. Adobe Enhance AI, if you've watched any video about it, is one of those tools where it takes the audio that you currently have. It can make it seem like you recorded a trash audio in a professional studio setup, and that kind of quality is something that everybody aspires to get. Personally speaking, from my experience, I would say it's better to try and record a good quality audio by yourself, then feed it into Adobe Enhance if the audio is not to your liking, as opposed to taking a bad quality audio and putting it through there, because it's not at a stage where you can classify it as witchcraft yet. It's just good enough. My seventh tool of choice would be Magic Eraser. Magic Eraser essentially is the tool where you can open it up on the web, you input your image, and then easily erase the parts that you don't need from an image, and the AI algorithm would replace it with what it assumes should be there based on the entire image. I find that this is a great tool. However, you can accomplish this tool using Photoshop and Stable Diffusion, as well as some plugin. It does have its uses in my day-to-day life because of its ease of use. I could easily open up the website without having to launch Stable Diffusion and launch the program through Photoshop for me to be able to use the combo together. I feel Magic Eraser, for what it does, is very efficient. You can easily open it up and do what you need to do, and it doesn't take a lot of steps. My eighth tool of choice is one I rarely use, but it is one that always wows me till this very day. It has been there before the whole hype of AI, and I always felt like it should have been more well known than it is. I'm not sure if they still do a free trial, but when I used it, there was a 30-day free trial. The tool I'm talking about is 10web AI. 10web AI is one of those tools where if you personally input a link to a website, it clones it and it makes an Elementor duplicate of that exact website. So not only can you clone an exact website to make a replica, you can manually edit the cloned copy, and it makes each part of the UI into an editable element. My ninth tool of choice is Nvidia Broadcast. Is something I use once in a while for live streams or whenever I want to do Zoom calls. I just turn it on, blur the background with the Adobe Broadcast AI. I never really use the audio segment of it because the audio part of it is not as good as the video part. It is one of those things where I do have hope that the audio will get better with time. I do have hope that they will eventually get good enough for mass consumption, but as of right now, it takes way too much of your system processing power, and it doesn't provide as good in audio as it does in video, so it is limited. And the one thing I would personally say could make it better would be if there was a way to record directly from the software. The only downside is that you would have to use a tool like OBS to record, and it's not the best tool you can use because it does have a lot of downsides in terms of quality reduction. Now, my final tool I use and I would recommend is Wisdolia. My last few sets of tools are not one that you use on a daily basis. However, they are very useful if you work from home or if you're looking to complete tasks as efficiently as possible. Wisdolia is one of those tools where you can use to create questions, kind of like Quizlet, but for websites. And what Wisdolia does essentially is it extracts a list of questions from a web page and makes it into a flashcard where you can ask yourself questions and answer them by flipping the flashcard over. And you can import these flashcards into Anki, which is kind of like a Quizlet, which is kind of like a flashcard program, which helps you retain information a lot easier. With that being said, those are my top 10 tools, and those are tools that I personally would recommend for anybody who needs to get any work done as efficiently as possible using AI tools that I use on my day-to-day basis, and not tools per se that are groundbreaking, but tools that I have tried and work and keep working for me. If you have any tools that you would recommend, please drop them below in the comment section. And if you have any questions, you can join the community Discord below. Thank you and take care. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and like button down below. That's all.